Health in Bangladesh, Wikipedia audio. Health levels remain relatively low in Bangladesh, although they have improved recently as poverty levels have decreased. To ensure equitable health care to every residing human in Bangladesh, an extensive network of health services has been established following the administrative web of Bangladesh. It is a circuitous form of healthcare network spread across the country, ranging from policy-making bodies to healthcare facilities down to the community level. Infrastructure of healthcare facilities can be divided into three levels: medical university, medical college hospitals, specialized hospitals exist at tertiary level. District hospitals, mother and child welfare centers considered as secondary level. Upazila Health Complex, Union Health and Family Welfare Centers, community clinics are the primary level healthcare providers. Various NGOs and private institutions also contribute to this intricate network. The total expenditure on healthcare as a percentage of Bangladesh's GDP was 3.35% in 2009. Health infrastructure. In the parliamentary budget of 2017-18, only the budget has been set for the health sector is 16,203 crore 36 lakhs Bangladeshi taka. The number of hospital beds per 10,000 population is 3. The general government expenditure on healthcare as a percentage of total government expenditure was 7.9% as of 2009, and the citizens pay most of their healthcare bills as the out-of-pocket expenditure as a percentage of private expenditure on health is 96.5%. Doctor to population ratio 1:2,000, nurse to population ratio 1:5,000. CDR 5.35/1000, maternal mortality ratio 176/1000, IMR 31/1000 live births. Under 5 MR 38/1000 live births, total fertility rate 2.1, life expectancy at birth 71 and 73, fully immunized children 52%. Due to huge number of population, Bangladesh faces double burden of diseases, non-communicable diseases, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, hypertension, stroke, chronic respiratory diseases, cancer and communicable diseases, tuberculosis, HIV, tetanus, malaria, measles, rubella, leprosy, and so on. The health problems of Bangladesh include communicable and non-communicable disease, malnutrition, environmental sanitation problems, and others. From historical aspect, it is known that communicable diseases formed major bulk of total diseases in developing and tropical countries such as Bangladesh. By 2015, via Millennium Development Goals, where communicable diseases were targeted, Bangladesh attained almost significant control on communicable diseases. An expanded immunization program against 9 major diseases was undertaken for implementation. However, recent statistics shows that non-communicable disease burden has increased to 61% of the total disease burden due to epidemiological transition. According to National NCD Risk Factor Survey in 2010, 99% of the survey population revealed at least one NCD risk factor and 29% showed greater than 3 risk factors. Social transition, rapid urbanization, and unhealthy dietary habit are the major stimulating reasons behind high prevalence of non-communicable diseases in Bangladesh. Remarkably, in underprivileged communities such as rural inhabitants, urban slum dwellers, indiscriminate defecation resulting in filth and waterborne disease like diarrhea, dysentery, enteric fever, hepatitis, hookworm infestations, poor rural housing with no arrangement for proper ventilation, lighting, etc., poor sanitation of public eating and marketplaces, inadequate drainage, disposal of refuse and animal waste, absence of adequate MCH care services, absence and/or adequate health education to the rural areas, absence and/or inadequate communications and transport facilities. For workers of the public health. Diabetes, one of four priority non-communicable diseases targeted by world leaders, has become a major health problem globally. More than two-thirds of diabetic adults are from low- and middle-income countries due to demographic changes, cultural transition, and population aging. Among dominant identified risk factor of burden of diseases in South Asian countries, diabetes is placed in seventh position. Remarkably, Bangladesh is placed in top 10th position among countries with highest number of diabetes adults in the world. Therefore, CO jointly with India and Sri Lanka, Bangladesh constituted 99.0% of the adult with high blood sugar in South Asian region. Previous studies show that prevalence of diabetes is increasing significantly in rural population of Bangladesh. It is also observed that females have higher prevalence of diabetes than male both in rural and urban areas. Lack of self-care, unhealthy dietary habit, and poor employment rate are the considerable factors behind that higher prevalence of diabetes among females in our country. However, compared with Europeans and Americans, the pattern of diabetes in Bangladesh displays differences, such as the onset is at younger age and major diabetic population is non-obese. Such clinical differences, limited access to health care, increased life expectancy, ongoing urbanization, and poor awareness among population increase the prevalence and risk of diabetes in Bangladesh. Belgium edition equals 7 URL equals http://www.diabetesatlas.org. The prevalence of diabetic retinopathy in Bangladesh is about one-third of the total diabetic population. These recent estimates are higher like Western countries and similar to Asian Malays living in Singapore. Sharp economic transition, urbanization, technology-based modern lifestyle, tight diabetes control guidelines and unwillingness to receive health care are thought to be the risk factors of diabetic retinopathy in Bangladesh. Unfortunately, to attain that emerging health problem, the current capacity in the country to diagnose and treat diabetic retinopathy is very limited to a few centers. Till this year, as per record of National Eye Care under HPNSDP, 10,000 people with diabetic retinopathy have received services from secondary and tertiary hospitals where the screening programs have been established. Hospitals. The most difficult problem to tackle in this country is perhaps the environmental sanitation problem, which is multifaceted and multifactorial. The twin problems of environmental sanitation are lack of safe drinking water in many areas of the country and preventive methods of excreta disposal. Bangladesh suffers from some of the most severe malnutrition problems. The present per capita intake is only 1,850 kilocalories, which is by any standard, much below required need. Malnutrition results from the convergence of poverty, inequitable food distribution, disease, illiteracy, rapid population growth and environmental risks, compounded by cultural and social inequities. Severe undernutrition exists mainly among families of landless agricultural laborers and farmers with small holding. Specific nutritional problems in the country are: deficiency of VITA. Child malnutrition in Bangladesh is amongst the highest in the world. Two-thirds of the children under the age of 5 are undernourished and about 60% of children under age 6 are stunted. As of 1985, more than 45% of rural families and 76% of urban families were below the acceptable caloric intake level. Malnutrition is passed on through generations as malnourished mothers give birth to malnourished children. About one-third of babies in Bangladesh are born with low birth weight, increasing infant mortality rate, and an increased risk of diabetes and heart ailments in adulthood. One neonate dies in Bangladesh every 3 to 4 minutes, 120,000 neonates die every year. The World Bank estimates that Bangladesh is ranked first in the world of the number of children suffering from malnutrition. In Bangladesh, 26% of the population are undernourished and 46% of the children suffers from moderate to severe underweight problem. 43% of children under 5 years old are stunted. 1 in 5 preschool age children are vitamin A deficient and 1 in 2 are anemic. Women also suffer most from malnutrition. To provide their family with food, they pass on quality food which are essential for their nutrition. Most terrain of Bangladesh is low-lying and is prone to flooding. A large population of the country lives in areas that are at risk of experiencing extreme annual flooding that brings large destruction to the crops. Every year, 20% to 30% of Bangladesh is flooded. Floods threaten food security and their effects on agricultural production cause food shortage. Medical schools. Health status. The health and sanitation environment also affects malnutrition. Inadequacies in water supply, hygiene, and sanitation have direct impacts on infectious diseases, such as malaria, parasitic diseases, and schistosomiasis. People are exposed to both water scarcity and poor water quality. Groundwater is often found to contain high arsenic concentration. Sanitation coverage in rural areas was only 35% in 1995. Demographics. Health indicators. Health problems in Bangladesh. Communicable disease. Non-communicable disease. Almost 1 in 3 people in Bangladesh defecates in the open among the poorest families. Only 32% of the latrines in rural areas attain the international standards for a sanitary latrine. People are exposed to feces in their environment daily. The immune system falls and the disease processes exacerbate loss of nutrients, which worsens malnutrition. The diseases also contribute through the loss of appetite, lowered absorption of vitamins and nutrients, and loss of nutrients through diarrhea or vomiting. Unemployment and job problems also lead to malnutrition in Bangladesh. In 2010, the unemployment rate was 5.1%. People do not have working facilities all year round and they are unable to afford the minimum cost of a nutritious diet due to the unsteady income. Undernourished mothers often give birth to infants who will have difficulty growing up and developing into a healthy teenager. They develop health problems such as wasting, stunting, underweight, anemia, night blindness and iodine deficiency. As a result, Bangladesh has a high child mortality rate and is ranked 57 in the under 5 mortality rank. Diabetes. As 40% of the population in Bangladesh are children, malnutrition and its health effects among children can potentially lead to a lower educational attainment rate. Only 50% of an age group of children in Bangladesh managed to enroll into secondary school education. This would result in a low-skilled and low-productivity workforce which would affect the economic growth rate of Bangladesh with only 3% GDP growth in 2009. Many programs and efforts have been implemented to solve the problem of malnutrition in Bangladesh. UNICEF, together with the government of Bangladesh and many other NGOs such as Helen Keller International, focus on improving the nutritional access of the population throughout their life cycle from infants to the child-bearing mother. The impacts of the intervention are significant. Night blindness has reduced from 3.76% to 0.04%, and iodine deficiency among school-aged children has decreased from 42.5% to 33.8%. 1 in 8 women receive delivery care from medically trained providers, and fewer than half of all pregnant women in Bangladesh seek antenatal care. Inequity in maternity care is significantly reduced by ensuring the accessibility of health services. The 2010 maternal mortality rate per 100,000 births for Bangladesh is 340. This is compared with 338.3 in 2008 and 724.4 in 1990. In Bangladesh, the number of midwives per 1,000 live births is 8 and the lifetime risk of death for pregnant women 1 in 110. Eye disease related to diabetes. Environmental sanitation. Malnutrition. Causes of malnutrition. Effects of malnutrition in Bangladesh. Health effects. Economic effects. Efforts to combat malnutrition. Maternal and child health.